Welcome to weekdaychurch.com. Hope you had a wonderful weekend. This week we're going to be dealing with the doctrine of man. And the very first one is, why did God create man? Most of us have asked this question before, of why am I here? Why do I even exist? Is there any purpose to this, or is it all just a big accident? Well, that's what we're going to be talking about today. Let's open in prayer. Our Heavenly Father, we know that you put us here for a reason. We believe that in faith. And I believe that you love us. And God, I thank you so much for creating me and creating the rest of us, and that we are here for a purpose. And God, I pray that we will live according to that purpose, and we give you glory and honor for creating us, for loving us, for putting us here, and for putting us in your image. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Our opening song today is by Rich Mullins. It's called Creed. And I really hope that you enjoy this song and that there's a good teaching in here about the things that we believe. A lot more in the song than just on creation, but it does talk about how God made us. And so I'll see you right after the song.
I believe in God the Father, Almighty Maker of heaven and Maker of earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only begotten Son. Conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, he was crucified and dead and buried. And I believe what I believe, it's what makes me what I am. I did not make it, no, it is making me, it is the very truth of
one of the meanest things a parent can say to a kid is, You were an accident. I never wanted to have you. I never wanted to get pregnant. You're only here because, well, an accident happened. Well, that can break even a grown adult's heart if they hear that. They're like, oh, well, I didn't know that. You know, I thought you'd wanted me. And if a child hears that, how much worse? You know, it's one of the meanest things that a parent can say to a child, whether they say it just to be mean or whether it just sort of slips out on accident. It really can hurt their feelings. And evolution screams to all of us, you are an accident. This all just happened because, well, some soup got hit by lightning and then life began. Or a big bang of nothing exploded and life began. And it could have happened anyway, but it might not have. And all the chain events that happened after that finally led to you, but there's no purpose behind it. And why are you here? Well, just an accident. So you end up with sort of the Epicurean mindset of, we may as well eat, drink, and, you know, just do whatever we want, because tomorrow we die. That kind of an idea, because if I'm just an accident, there's no reason to be here. But that's not true. Why did God create man? It says in Colossians 1, verse 16, for by him, this is Jesus, all things were created, in heaven and on earth, visible and invisible, whether thrones or dominions or rulers or authorities, all things were created through him and for him. You were created, and you were created for a purpose. Why did God create you? God created you for him. That's why. Jesus made you to be with him. He wants you. He loves you. You were not an accident. You were made on purpose. He wanted you to be exactly the person that you are. You look the way you look because he wanted you to look like that. Now you may say, well, I've put on a few pounds. Well, that might have been your choice. But you know, the things that you have, the color of your hair, how tall you are, how short you are. He says, you know, worrying about that doesn't make you any bigger. It doesn't add any length to your life. Why? Because God made us the way that we are. And not only did he make us for him, it says in Genesis 1:27 that God created man in his own image. In the image of God, he created him. Male and female, he created them. And in Genesis 2, verse 7, it says, then the Lord God formed the man of the dust from the ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and man became a living creature. God took you and formed you and fashioned you and breathed his life into you, making you in his image. There are many things about the image of God that we could talk about, the things that we share with God. But today I just want to stick with one main point. God made you for one reason, to be with him. God loves you. He wanted you here, and he desperately wants a relationship with you. You are not an accident. You were created on purpose in the very image of God. He created you because he loves you, and he created you because he wants to know you. He wants to have a relationship with you. So you say, well, what's the application? Know God. That's the application. Get to know him. You say, well, how do I get to know him? Jesus says this, that you cannot know the Father without knowing him. He is the only way to the Father. So if you want to know God, you know God through his Son. Know Jesus Christ. If you haven't accepted Jesus Christ, that's where you start. Accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior and get to know God. As you know God, you will grow through knowing his Son. Spend time with Jesus. Talk to Jesus. Listen to Jesus. Hear from God's Holy Spirit. Know God through his Holy Spirit. He said, I must go, Jesus said, but I will send my Spirit to be with you. God's Holy Spirit is who lives in the life of his people. He said he would never leave us nor forsake us. What an exciting thing to think. God created you so much because he wants a relationship with you. And he's doing so much to have that relationship with you that he sent his only begotten Son so that that relationship that we broke through sin could be restored. And then he said, I will send my Spirit on top of that so that I can always be with you. And he will give us his Word. God has given us His Bible. That's why we bring up the Bible every day on weekday church, because God has given us His Word, and one of the greatest ways we can know Him is through His work. And lastly, know God through His people. The Bible says that others will know that we are Christians by the love that we share for one another, for other Christians. Know God through His people. If each person you meet has the image of God on them, if each Christian you meet has the Holy Spirit in them, the relationship that you share with those people draws you closer to the God who created those people in His image. The more you know about them, the more you know about Him. So get to know God. That's the application. Why are you here? To know Him. And if you say, my life has no purpose and meaning, then know God more. That is the purpose and meaning of your life. That is the whole reason you were created, is to know God. You can look for purpose and meaning in many other things, and there are many other things. If you go through Genesis 1 and 2, you will find many things that you were created to do. To have dominion, to have animals in your life, and to be around them, to spend time with them, to spend time with other people, to work. You'll find all kinds of reasons that you'll make, and you can find some fulfillment in life through those. But if you take away the number one reason you were made, which is to be with God, you will never find complete fulfillment. That is the beginning and the end of why you are here. All the rest of it is just extras. So get to know God, love Him, and spend time with Him. And we'll be talking more about this as we go through the week. Our closing song is Draw Me Close. I think it'll be a real encouragement, because that's what we're talking about, is drawing close to God. So listen to the words of this song. We're going to close in prayer. And I hope you have a wonderful day. Heavenly Father, as we come to close, I pray that we will draw closer to You. If there's anyone here who's listening and needs to accept You in salvation, I pray that that's what they will do, that they will invite Jesus Christ to be their Savior so they can have a relationship with You. And Heavenly Father, for those of us who already know You and are watching this, God, I pray that we will constantly draw closer to You, as we see in this song, as we can draw closer in worship. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Jesus, draw me close to You. Never let me go. Never let me go.